Last time on the NCA.
Dreaming about Grave Robber versus Chaz Michael Michaels, the Ice Break Kid. 4 years in the making. What does this fucktard want?
Give yourself to the dark side.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to NCA Nitro. I am Justin71. Here's a little backstory for you. In Classic Nitro, there's a confrontation between Guy Gardner and Chaz Michael Michaels. Cade Skywalker. Ah, I'm dumb. I totally botched. Alright, so there's a confrontation between Cade Skywalker and Guy Gardner. And Guy Gardner tried to kill Cade with fire. This is what happens when Joseph provides me with caffeine. He can do that? Oh yeah, Disney World. What the fuck? That's Jax's music. He's been seen on NCA Friday night. This is his first time. He said, fuck. Ladies and gentlemen, now we're having an unprecedented match here. Jax versus Cade Skywalker. Jax is undefeated in NCA. Has not been pinned. Advantage Jax. As quickly as I say that, Code of Cade out of nowhere. Stick a fork in him. No! is about ready to kill Cade Skywalker's momentum. No, Cade kicks out. This is awesome. I don't have a mouse talking in my ear telling me what to say and what not to say. DDT on the ring apron. I'm going to call a match. I'm not going to tell a fucking story here. Advantage Jax. A win for Jax in this would put him in contention for the NXT title for sure. But there you heard it. Whoa! Mid-rope DDT, Randy Orton style. Move of Mayhem! Out of nowhere! One, two, three, no! Cade somehow fights back. Reverse neckbreaker. One, two. These guys are not holding anything back. These are big gun moves. Cade kicks back and reversal of Code of Cade. I've yet to see that be done. One, two, and no. Cade's out in the ring apron. Got thrown out of the ring. I think that's a mistake on Jax's part. He had him. He has Cade winded. And Cade fought back. Cade clutch. You can't get a submission win on the floor. This match might end in a count out here, and that would suck. I gotta say this, for a rookie, hey, Move of Mayhem got turned into Code of Cade. One, two, and three. I'll give Jax credit here. He took the fight to Cade Skywalker like in a way I've never seen it done before. Not since Prime. But needless to be said, there's your winner, Cade Skywalker. Alright, and what we're going to do here is I've been informed that we're going to see what led up to this number one contenders match for the NCAA world title between Guy Gardner and Cade Skywalker. Let's see how it all began.
And the cavalry has arrived, making sure the evil empire will not interfere. No Superman Prime, no Bad News Bison who thinks he has a job because he believes in things like himself. They're here to make the save. So he deserves it. What the fuck? Cade! Why? Why, Cade? Why? Crimes against humanity! What the blue hell? Cade! How can you turn your back on the NCAA galaxy like this? This is horrible!
Who do you think was behind this whole thing? I just want to let you know, I own Marvel, I own Star Wars. Welcome to the Disney World Order, motherfuckers!
Code of Cade!
That's right! Now go have a pin his ass! It's good for business!
No! Not like this! Not like this!
Skywalker, Guy Gardner, number one contenders match. And there he is, fresh off of his Revelations defeat. I think this is his first match since losing to the Zohan at Revelations. He came yay close in that 2 out of 3 fall match. But Dashing Dick Grayson is going to be taking on the other number one contender for the NCAA world title, Guy Gardner. A win by Dashing Dick Grayson could put him back in contention. And who knows what else that could potentially do for his career. Guy Gardner's new theme song. Yeah! Fight, Gardner, fight! This should be no cakewalk for Guy Gardner. He's facing the man right now that beat him for the Coast to Coast Championship. And actually fended off all Guy Gardner's challenges, furthermore to add. Yeah, and might I add, Guy Gardner has left Dashing Dick Grayson disfigured at one point. But there you go. Here is our mega rematch here. And they're ready to go. Toe drop takedown by Dashing Dick. Advantage Grayson working the knees in the lower extremities. I gotta say, this is one very, very, very evenly matched contest here. In the deck! And Dashing Dick Grayson reverses it. Reversal by Guy Gardner. Guy Gardner, sir, doing his own version of the Cade Clutch here. I don't know if he's sending a message to Cade Skywalker, but... Ah, DDT on the ring apron! That seems to be a recurring theme right now. As sharpshooter by Dashing Dick. I thought it was setting him up for Walls of Bloodhaven, but that's something you see closer to the end of a match of Dashing Dick Grayson. 1, 2, and no! It's going to take a hell of a lot more than that to take out Guy Gardner. Both Guy Gardner and Cade Skywalker both in some serious action here tonight. And win by Dashing Dick Grayson puts him back in the title picture. Corkscrew off the top rope. One, two, no, not even a two count. That type of move would put just about anyone away. One, two, and no. Snake Eyes on the second rope. Sky Gardner setting up Dashing Dick for Walls of Bloodhaven. His own finishing move. Dashing Dick fights back. Another top rope corkscrew move. Is he setting up Walls of Bloodhaven? Is Guy gonna tap out? No, he does not. Flying body press. And moonsault. And Dashing Dick catches him on the top rope. One, two, and no. And is he doing it? Walls of Bloodhaven. And Guy Gardner fights out. That's the beer talking. Powerbomb, and he doesn't go for the pin. And is Guy Gardner saying his own version of Walls of Bloodhaven? What are we seeing here? A little nod to his old nemesis, Sinestro. Does he put him away? No. Twisting of the knife. This could be the beginning of the end here. Clearly, the beginning of the end. Stay out of nowhere! One, two, three! There's your number one contender, Guy Gardner, getting ready to face off against another number one contender, Kane Skywalker, who will be victorious and in your tube. Roxa, the former NCAA Hardcore Champion. That's sad and somber. We don't know why Dr. Roxa is here. I don't think he's scheduled for a match, to the best of my knowledge. He does not look good, and you know, there's been rumors, anything from failing a wellness policy test to him announcing his retirement. But needless to be said, an impromptu appearance by Dr. Roxo, the rock and roll clown. The man who does lots and lots of cocaine. Don't do it, Roxo. You're in no shape for this. Even Charlie Sheen doesn't have enough good cocaine for this. Standing
by. Red 2, standing by.
Red 11. The force is with you.
I hope you know what you're doing, Roxo. Do you know what you're doing? Oh, dear God, this is not going to go well for Dr. Roxo. He's got to face Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. I mean, Luke and Anakin Skywalker. This is not a wise move at all.